interviewer wants to understand that, do you understand when to use what? That's what the interviewer's goal would be. So if you can tell that, yes, for production, we will definitely need a direct connect gateway. Why? Because production needs speed, production data needs reliability, and production data needs security, and we don't mind spending few bucks more in order to ensure that our production is up and running all the time and is secure. Friends, here's the fact. We will never be 100% on cloud. Never. If you are a small startup, it's different. But if you are a mid-size or a large-size company, chances are you will always have something on your on-prem data center while you will continue to migrate stuff or build new stuff on cloud. So there will never be a point where you will completely cut off your connections from your on-prem data center, and thus you need hybrid networking. And hybrid networking allows you to connect your on-prem data center with your cloud. So in this video, we'll talk about two most common ways how any company will try to connect their on-prem resources to the cloud. And while we are taking AWS cloud for this particular video, exactly same services are there on Google Cloud and Azure. So you can understand this concept and apply it on other clouds as well. Secondly, we'll also touch base upon some interesting real life example to contextualize this whole thing. And lastly, we'll take a company XYZ use case, which will be very handy for you in case you are getting any interview based scenario based questions in your interview. You could be applying for a cloud engineer role, a cloud architect role, or any role for that matter. A basic networking knowledge is asked by almost anybody. So stay till the end, and I'm sure by the end of this video, you'll have something very tangible to express your networking knowledge during interviews and your overall understanding about hybrid networking. So let's get started. So imagine two different scenarios in the real life. For example, Mr. Prime Minister of a country wants to make a travel through the airport, then there will be a dedicated road or a dedicated tunnel built for the Prime Minister, and he will directly use this road or this tunnel and straight away go through the airport and board the flight, which will be obviously a very special flight, especially for the Prime Minister. But for general public, there would be the normal route. It is the public transport which they have to take, the public roads they have to take to reach to the airport. Okay, now what's the difference? The difference is very evident. In this particular route, it is very direct, so obviously it will be faster, it will be secure, because there is nobody else traveling through this particular road. It is very, very secure, but obviously it will take time to build, because it's a dedicated road or a dedicated tunnel. And obviously if it is being made like this, it will be expensive. Whereas the general public will take the route which will be slower, for example, okay, because there will be other people traveling on the road, then, you know, obviously it will be cheaper because these roads are used for all the different purposes. But yes, obviously going through this route, deploying this whole route would be faster, because obviously you do not need any dedicated road for general public. So there are pros and cons to both. Okay, so now understand this, that this method, number one method and number two method, are the primary method to connect your on-prem with the cloud. And the number one method on AWS cloud, which is exactly similar on GCP and Azure, is AWS Direct Connect. Okay, this is Mr. Prime Minister's method. Okay, and the second one is AWS VPN, okay, which is also called as S2S, site-to-site VPN. AWS S2S, site-to-site VPN. For example, in GCP, the same service is called Google Cloud Dedicated Interconnect. Okay, so and then there are VPN services as well. But don't bother about that. Understand that what is the difference between a direct connect and a VPN. So as the name suggests, it is a direct connection, and it is really fast, it is really secure, but obviously expensive. Whereas this VPN service is over the internet, over the public internet. So obviously it is going to be cheaper, but then it will be slower, and it can be used for lower bandwidth use cases. So we will use VPN in those particular cases. So now let's understand, a direct comparison between the direct connect and the site-to-site VPN, and then we'll understand more detail when we'll discuss about the business case. So let's understand the exact features of these two. So these are some differences between Direct Connect and VPN. Direct Connect, as the name suggests, is a private connection. It's a dedicated connection, whereas this is over the internet, like any other VPN service. Bandwidth is very high, up to 100 Gbps is the offering by AWS, and it will vary from cloud to cloud. But here it is slower. It is only 1.25 because it is over the internet. So it will also depend on your internet speed. Very reliable. It is comparatively less reliable. If your router goes off, if your internet goes off, you have lost the connectivity. So cloud providers won't say anything on that. It takes time to build. Okay, so because dedicated interconnect is something where you have to come to a place where both the on-premise and the cloud come together at a place where they can connect their services. So for that, it takes time to build. It is faster. You can deploy the VPN very quickly. It is very costly compared to... So the setup cost is higher here, but once the setup cost is done, the data transfer cost is lower. Whereas here, it is cheaper to build it up, set it up. But over the time, the overall data transfer cost will be higher here, because then you will also include the internet charges. Very secure compared to VPN, because it is very dedicated. There is no chance of intrusion. Obviously, there is always the risk. But when you have a dedicated network between your on-prem and your cloud, then the risk is very low. Whereas when you are going over the internet, there could be a DDoS attack, there could be different kinds of attack. We have also created a series on cybersecurity. You can check it in the playlist. We have talked about all these kind of different attacks there. This is primarily used for critical workloads, and this is for non-critical workloads, but we'll come to this when we'll take our company use case. By the way, guys, if you're new to cloud or you're looking to build your career, start your career on cloud, especially AWS as a beginner, then I'll definitely recommend you to check the link in the description and in the pinned comment. So friends, before we touch base on the actual company XYZ use case, which will again be asked in your interviews as a scenario based question, let's understand some salient features of these two methods. So Direct Connect has two different types. One is dedicated and another is partner. As the name suggests, in dedicated, AWS cloud and your on-premise data center has to come to a co-location facility where the connection could happen physically. If that's not possible, then you could choose one of the approved third-party providers or vendors who provide this service between your on-prem data center and AWS cloud. So they will take this whole responsibility of setting this physical connection. Okay, so for very big, large use cases where the data volume is huge, security needs to be paramount. The companies generally go for dedicated, but wherever it is less critical, people choose partner Direct Connect. So it is faster compared to this, but then obviously there are downfalls as to you will have dependency on the partner all the time. There is a concept in Direct Connect which is called as virtual interfaces. Something similar to VLANs. So basically what happens is when you set up Direct Connect, there would be different highway lanes of sorts, okay, created for different kind of data needs. So while it will be a direct connection, the data will have its own lanes to transfer from on-prem to the cloud, and it is called as VIPs. It basically isolates all the different kinds of traffic. And basically there are three types of VIFs, virtual interfaces, which are generally used. So the number one is the private. So the private is a point-to-point connection between your on-prem resources and the resources on the cloud. But because it is point-to-point, the restriction it can only connect to resources within one VPC. If you do not know what is a VPC, and if you are wondering what is a VPC, you can again go to my comment section and my description and see the AWS for Complete Beginner course. It will clarify everything. And if you want to start your career on cloud, I think that course will cover all those fundamentals for you. And just in case if you can't afford that or you don't want to enroll for that, go and watch my Google Cloud series. And there we have discussed VPC in more detail. So the concept remains the same. The second is public. And public is a virtual interface wherein whatever traffic is flowing is generally trying to connect to the public resources which are provided by AWS, like S3 bucket or all different kind of cloud services. But then you will have your direct connection to these services, these public resources provided by AWS, DynamoDB, all kind of different services. There are plethora of services, so I've just used S3 as a reference. The third one is transit gateway. Now transit, as you might have seen in the airport, transit is a place from where you go to various directions, okay, and that becomes your transit. So the beauty with a transit is that it will end at a transit gateway. Like here it is a virtual private gateway where it ends. Here it will end at a transit gateway. What is a gateway? Gateway is a door through which you connect to a different world. Just understand like that. So in the transit gateway, what you can have multiple VPCs. So virtual private connection VPCs you could have, and that will that is again a different architecture based on your need. Okay, it all depends. There could be different kinds of design patterns we can talk about, but transit gateway is used. And then there is another gateway. Actually, there are so many gateways. Maybe if you want, I can make another video specifically on gateways. But there is a dedicated direct connect gateway again. So the direct connect gateway again helps to connect the traffic from direct connect to multiple VCCs using transit gateway. So these are different gateways which are available within AWS to enable the end-to-end networking. On the VPN side, there's nothing much. The basic feature is it uses IPsec protocol over the internet, and then generally whatever a VPN service provides remains the same for side-to-side VPN as well. And apart from this, there are other ways also to connect, but I'm not going into those details because these are the primary two I want to focus on. But if you want, I'll link down some resources from where you can understand in more detail what are other ways to connect between your on-prem and your cloud. So now enough of this. Now let's go to our architecture. Let's understand how a company XYZ would fulfill its requirement using these two different methods. So now let's take a business use case for company XYZ. For example, company XYZ has requirements where it needs to connect its data center to AWS cloud for two different use cases. One is a development use case, which will be a development environment where the non-critical workloads like developers checking in the code, developers taking the remote desktop access for some EC2 instances on the cloud will happen. And then there has to be a production environment which is highly resilient, secure, and has a proper failover and disaster recovery. So these are the two scenarios. And if suppose interviewer asks you to design an architecture, how you will connect or how you will design your architecture, then this could be one of the methods. There are numerous patterns, guys, which you could come up for, but this is the most easiest way to understand these two methods. So number one is the direct connect, and for the direct connect we will have a co-location. We are taking a direct connect without partner, so there will be a co-location where you will have, you know, these are depicted as routers, so it could be any resource from your company. So you will have a co-location, so you your company router will be here, and then you will have your AWS direct connect router here, and there will be a connection setup, and then there will be a direct connect gateway. We talked about AWS direct connect gateway, which helps you connect to multiple VPCs within AWS. So till here you have established your direct connect. On the AWS cloud side, you have deployed everything in one region. You can also have it in multiple regions using different patterns. So for simplicity's sake, we have one single region, and within that we have deployed our production VPC, two different VPCs. VPC, so it is a virtual private connection or a network wherein you have your production one VPC and production two for a better failover. And then you have a transit gateway. If you remember, the transit gateway allows you to connect to multiple VCC, not only one VPC. So that's why we are using transit gateway here. Similarly, you will have some data which has to be stored in S3 bucket, and for that you will have the connectivity with AWS public services. So if you can recall, we have the concept of virtual interfaces. So here you will have a public WIF, okay, virtual interface, wherein here you will have a transit one because we are using the transit gateway. Okay, so it will be the transit one. And now once you are connected with this, then you can you can connect to both the VPCs and transfer the data across. Now the other use case is for the developers who want to do the development work and non-critical work. For that we have the development VPC created here. AZ1, AZ2, these are availability zones. We need not to go into that detail. You need to understand the core services first. So let me know if you want, or you can check the link in the description and the pinned comment to learn AWS as a complete beginner. The second method is of site-to-site VPN, which is again over the internet. Through the over internet, it is coming to the virtual private gateway. As we said, virtual private gateway has a point-to-point connectivity. So it will only be able to connect to one VPC at one time. So that's why we have used virtual private gateway, and it is directly connecting to VPC for development. So as you can see, whatever we have discussed, we have tried deploying in this design pattern. There could be numerous design pattern, but if the interviewer wants to understand that, do you understand when to use what? That's what the interviewer's goal would be. So if you can tell that, yes, for production, we will definitely need a direct connect gateway. Why? Because production needs speed, production data needs reliability, and production data needs security, and we don't mind spending few bucks more in order to ensure that our production is up and running all the time and is secure. Whereas for development environment, we don't need that level of criticality. It's not that critical. It can be slower, so we can use site-to-site VPN. So yes, guys, these are the two methods with which we can create hybrid networking. So guys, if you want to learn VPN in more basic manner, then there would be a video link to this particular video. You can check that video. And until next time, guys, let me know in the comment section if you learned something new from this video and what kind of topics you would want me to make videos on on this channel. We will be learning more about cloud in the coming series, in the coming videos. So let me know your ideas, and I'll try to make some videos and tutorials for you guys. So until next time, as we keep saying, keep learning, keep sharing all your knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.